My name is Damianos Marinatos, and I'm a physiotherapist at Igea Hospital, specifically the third orthopedic department, working under Dr. Adonianakis. A big thank you to my colleagues who presented. Now is my turn to present our approach to the therapy plan for adhesive capsulitis. The adhesive capsulitis was analyzed by our doctors in a pre-course webinar. I will therefore share our approach with this particular patient. First contact with the patient was at the pre-op evaluation the day before surgery. We discussed her shoulder problem in collaboration with the doctor. We recorded the range of motion, we measured her muscle strength and her pain levels using a VAS pain scale. We informed the patient of what to expect post-surgery. We showed her the first exercises to do post-surgery, as well as show her how to use the arm brace. We reassured her that all would be fine. The second contact with the patient was post-surgery for an evaluation. We reassured her again that the surgery went well and explained again the rehab exercises she needed to begin. She was informed again how to use the arm brace correctly. The patient was anxious and in pain. We helped her to understand that adhesive capsulitis does not go away completely, so it is possible to continue feeling pain for a certain amount of time. The doctor resolved the mechanical problem, so our goal is to maintain the range of motion that was gained with the thylakotomy during surgery. We didn't focus on the supraspinatus stitches, but instead on her immediate mobilization. It's important to note that although the patient presented with a small tear in the supraspinatus tendon, her customized rehab treatment was for adhesive capsulitis and therefore started on the third day post-surgery, since it was important for her to maintain mobility quickly and safely. The third contact with the patient was to change her bandage 3 days after surgery. I was with the doctor and we discussed how she felt and encouraged her that everything would be okay. After changing her bandages, I showed her the first stretching exercises, which included external rotation from zero, internal rotation, forward flexion, abduction, and forward flexion to abduction. It was important to emphasize that she refrained from doing the stretches if she felt any pain. I mentioned that this rehab program needed to be performed with multiple daily repetitions of a short duration. I continuously suggested to her to move her arm as much as possible. It was necessary for her to understand how to listen to her arm and body and not to exert herself if she felt any pain. As a department, our goal is to have the patient return to fully dependent mobility as soon as possible. In addition, I gave her the first exercises for the scapular muscles that she had to perform once or twice a day, according to her level of pain. In the beginning of the therapy, she did the following scapular movements: elevation, protraction, retraction, and depression on her side. We emphasized strengthening the scapula in order to retrain the patient with the right pattern of shoulder function. I stayed with her as long as necessary, so I could explain to her the four rules that we follow as a department in order to complete the physio program with minimal pain. The four rules are: move slowly, stop stretching until patient feels tension, assistant function, and repetitions. We don't want the patient to rush movements and feel pain, so we emphasize moving slowly. We advise the patient to stop the exercises as soon as he feels any pain. We want the patient to continue moving her arm with the assistance of her other arm so as to not tire her weak arm. The patient is advised to continue doing the exercises as much as she can, regardless of how many repetitions I suggest. Again, it is emphasized to stop when she feels pain or is tired. I also explained the biomechanics of the shoulder movement, as we believe it is important for the patient to understand so as not to repeat future injuries. Our approach. An important aspect of our program is the constant collaboration between the doctor and the physiotherapist, as we believe it is essential for the best rehabilitation result. The patient in this way feels secure with minimal stress. As a department, we do not use predetermined protocols, but instead design a customized therapy approach for the patient. Our goal is to provide the patient with the necessary tools to achieve full independence as quickly as possible. 1 week post-surgery, we evaluated her situation by measuring her range of motion and her pain levels. We demonstrated and assigned new exercises accordingly. We continued to meet with the patient once a week as to help the patient achieve full independence as quickly as possible. In every session, I encouraged and supported her to continue the therapy program. While she was doing the stretching exercises, I was also giving her exercises for the rotator cuff muscles. We began to do these exercises with the passive stabilization of the scapula while she was on her back due to the help of gravity. In other words, active and assisted exercises. We then continued the exercises while she was on her side and followed up and from a standing position using resistance bands and weights. In her therapy program, which had stretching and strengthening exercises to increase her full range of motion, I also included open and closed kinetic chain exercises when she was able to do them. After 3 months, her range of motion had increased with a forward flexion of 160 degrees, abduction 160 degrees, external rotation at 40 degrees, and internal rotation at thoracic 12. The patient was feeling less pain than before, and she was able to do her daily activities with more ease. And here is the video of 3 months post-surgery. Abduction. External rotation until 40. External rotation from 90 degrees abduction. And internal rotation. After 4 months, we met for a session every 2 weeks and we continued her strengthening exercises gradually once a day, as well as her stretching exercise of short duration multiple times a day. Within 6 months after surgery, the patient's range of motion was complete and her pain levels had decreased substantially, and gradually she was able to go to the gym and to resume her daily activities. At 6 months post-surgery, we stopped the physiotherapy sessions, but were in touch for any issues she had. This is a video of the 6 months post-surgery. It's completed. We are now 9 months post-surgery, and she feels very little pain when she puts her arm in extreme positions, and she is able to resume her daily activities in full. She continues to do stretching exercises daily and strengthening 3 times a week. She does not take any painkillers, and she is pleased. This is now a week ago. Last but not least, we remind the patient that ultimately they are responsible for their own recovery and that the rehabilitation process is dependent on their own efforts. We are just the facilitators. Thank you for your attention.